I'm confused. I thought the answer to this was 0. Okay, let's take a look. We are going to find the total area bounded by y is equal to sin x from 0 to 2 pi. Area, we should use integral, right? Okay, let's go ahead and integrate. We are going to go from 0 to 2 pi. And the function is sin x. Let's see how we integrate this. Well, the derivative of what will give us positive sin x? The answer for that is negative cosine x. Because the derivative just cosine x is negative sine x, we need another negative to end up positive sine x. And then we will have to plug in 0 and 2 pi. 2 pi goes in here first, so negative cosine of 2 pi. That's the first part. And then minus, plugging 0 into here. So that's negative cosine of 0. Now, cosine 2 pi is equal to 1. Similarly, cosine 0 is also equal to 1. Why? Because if you look at the unit circle real quick, cosine is the x value, which is right here. At 2 pi, you see the x coordinate is 1, the y coordinate is 0. At 2 pi, you get 1 for cosine. And at 0, you also get 1 for cosine. So this right here is negative 1, minus minus becomes plus, and then we have another 1. So altogether, negative 1 plus 1 is equal to 0. Well, be careful now. If the question was asking you to compute this integral, then yes, the answer would be 0. But the question is asking us for the total area. So let's actually take a look at the picture. So we are talking about sin x. Sin x starts at 0, right here, and it goes up, down, and then back up. And this is 0, this is pi, here is 2 pi. And as we can see, we are talking about this region and this region together. Can this picture right here and right here give us an area of 0? No, because we can actually see that there's a region. So why is that we get a 0 though? Be careful now. We can use integrals to help us get area, but you have to keep in mind that area is never negative, right? But however, for integrals, sometimes it can be negative or sometimes it can be 0. Here's the deal. If the curve is above the x-axis, when you compute the integral on this interval, which is going from 0 to pi of sine x, this will give you positive result. And then if you look at this part right here, because the curve is below the x-axis, so if you compute the integral going from pi to 2 pi and then the sine x function, this integral will give you negative result. Why? Because you have negative y value here. So, as you can see, this and that are the same size, but this is going to give you a positive number, while this will give you the negative version of that number. So when you combine them, you get 0. And that's why when you go from 0 to 2 pi like this, you get 0 for the integral. So what do we do though if you want to find the total area? Well, here's how you can fix it. If you look at the picture, this right here is positive, so it doesn't matter. But if it's below the x-axis, well, you can just go ahead and put an absolute value around the result. Well, another way to do it is, because this and that are the same size, you can just go ahead and compute this integral here, get the area, and then double it, one way or the other. But I'm going to show you guys this way right here. Okay, so for this, I will just have to integrate it, which is negative cosine x, and then we go from 0 to pi, and plugging pi, you get negative cosine of pi. And then plugging 0, you get negative cosine of 0. Cosine pi, well, pi is right over there, and the x value for that is negative 1. So this right here is negative 1. Negative negative 1 gives us positive 1. And then cosine 0 is 1, but this is minus a negative, becomes a plus. and then this is 1. So as you can see, this integral right here gives us 2 for the red one. But if you look at the blue one, well, if you compute it, I'll tell you the blue part inside, you will end up with negative 2. But we don't want that for the area. Make sure you take the opposite value for that. So you will see this right here actually gives you positive 2. Therefore, if you come back here and answer the question, the total area will just be 2 from here and then 2 from here. So of course, 2 plus 2, we get 4. And that's the answer. Alright? So this right here is still not so bad. Let me tell you though, you can also do the following for the total area. Just make sure that you don't want to have negative parts, right? You can just do this. Don't do that, but instead, just integrate it from 0 to 2 pi, and then sine x with the opposite value. So this right here, you can put the negative part, you can kick that above the positive part, and then integrate this, maybe on a graphing calculator, so that you can get the result. Because if you want to do this by hand, you actually have to break down into cases. Hopefully this right here helps. That's it.